Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back. North Coast Constrictors, it's Carl here. All right, I've tried to start this video about three times already, but I'm doing this without any help. And you can hear I'm out of breath. It's because I've been chasing this girl all over. She's been wrapping around things. Normally I've got someone to help me, but today I don't. I want to talk about something that everybody hates talking about because every breeder wants them to. Everyone else, I think that I can get it. Mats, guys, you get it. You can go to a pet shop, you can get it and bring it home. You can go to another snake breeder and you can hold one of their snakes and you can get a mat and you can bring it home inadvertently. Doesn't mean that you're a bad breeder. Everybody gets mats. You just got to treat them. You got to catch them out and you got to treat them. So there's two or three different ways we're going to treat this. First of all, we're going to do a kill on-site treatment on the actual snake. Now, I saw she had some mats on her. So what I'm doing is I've got Frontline here. Frontline is a vet spray, a dog tick and flea spray. Okay, put it on a face cloth. All right, and then what I do is I wipe her down from head, okay, head to tail. All right, and this is to go. This is the mites that are on her body. Right now, I'm trying to keep her away from my dining room table there because she wraps herself around it. What this does here now, and I'm also, you got to watch the eyes. I also don't want to take a swipe. You got to get it around the neck, the eyes, underneath the belly. Okay? And she's aiming for that fucking table. And she just wants to get around the legs of that table. All right, and then I'll wipe her down before you get wrapped around there. Okay. And what I do is I wipe the snake down with this very, very, very powerful spray. Okay, Frontline. It is incredibly expensive. We're talking $800 a bottle. Okay, obviously if you can get the mats off while you're doing that, then that's what you do. Okay, use your nails through the cloth, pull the mats off. Okay, but this stuff will sit on the scales and within a few hours the mats will be dead. Okay, I've taken her water bowl out. So that she doesn't go into the water and then drink the water, okay? So you got to do that for about a day or two. All right, okay. So now that she's been thoroughly wiped down, and she's a big girl, thank goodness she's a very loving girl, and she's very trusting. I'm hoping you can get it in the picture here. Now, what I've already done, though, guys, is I have... see how that loves to lock. Oh, and she's gone around the fucking table again. Oh, I've got to get it out the side. Okay. Let me just... She's at the dining room table. Now, what I've already done without you guys watching is I sprayed down the interior of her enclosure with BioKill. Okay, so I'm going to put it back in her enclosure. And there's BioKill on the substrate. It's going to kill any mites on the substrate. Now, I know you guys are going to say, why did you change your fucking substrate and clean the tank? I just did. This is clean substrate. This is fresh substrate. I've just done it. Okay, no, back inside. In. Okay, so... Got a couple of mites, it will kill the mites. It will also kill any eggs. All right, and then what have I done with? Ah, shit, she's going out the other side. Back in you go. Thank you very much. Thanks for playing. All right, so let me get this closed. Okay. That was a bit of a mission. Okay, guys, so that's what I do to treat the snake straight away. This will kill. Let me get right up here. this will kill, we got this on, this will kill the mites on the snake, all right? And it's very powerful. So you've got to take the water out. Sorry about the lighting. I don't have a camera crew here. My girlfriend's not filming and not setting up any lights, okay? And as I say, I'm talking about a subject that no one likes to talk about. Okay, so the next thing we do, this is Vapona. Okay, that is a Tupperware. Vapona is poisonous. Okay. All right. Yellow like this, but if you about it looks like little chocolate blocks. If you look like that, all right, break into pieces. So what I do, the fumes of this, it cannot come into, the actual Vapona itself cannot come into contact with the snake. It will kill the snake. If she has to lick this or if it got into the water, it can kill the snake. Okay, so what you want is you want the fumes from the Vapona. Okay, so I cut a couple of pieces into a container like this. Okay. It's pretty expensive stuff, so you don't want to waste it. It lasts 3 months though, so I'm cutting it on the line where it gives you, because it's designed to break up into blocks. Okay, so I'm gonna put four blocks of Vapona, of this Vapona, into a Tupperware, which I've got holes on. Okay, there's, you see the holes on the top there, holes on the side. These are actually like my hatchling containers. Okay, so, and then what I do is I put this Vapona inside her enclosure. Put it in the middle there. Ah, and she's gonna want to come out again. Go back. I'll put it so she's gonna mess it around and it'll probably end up all over the place. So you gotta make sure that thing is nice and tight, okay? But now the fumes of that Vapona are very, very powerful, okay? So what it does is the fumes go out into the air, and she inhales the air, okay? And the air that she's inhaling goes into her bloodstream, okay? And her blood then, the mites sucking on her blood die. I know it sounds pretty hectic and like pretty whatever, but it's tried and tested, and it's done here in South Africa a lot. I don't know about America. I don't know if you get this in America, but this, yeah, everyone uses Vapona. Okay, in our ball python racks, we take just a block, just a single block like this. Okay, even half that size, and we put one block open like this in between each shelf. In between the tubs of the ball python racks, not inside the tub with the snake, because they're in a racking system, but that's open, there's no glass or whatever, and you put it inside, you put it on each shelf, one block on each shelf between the tubs. And these fumes, it's a mite prevention. Okay. So guys, that's how we're treating mites on this girl. And that container inside there now, those four blocks of Vapona, I've actually used four because this is a nice big tank. And now my phone will start ringing. It's so typical. So guys, that's a mite treatment. Let me just end that call. It's typical. She'll inhale, that's going to take about a couple of days, and then that enclosure will be completely mite free. So let me show you the two things that we use first here. Okay, I sprayed her down with this very, very powerful stuff. This is about how many milliliters? 500 milliliters, but this is about 800 bucks a bottle. This is 375 mils, but this is about 80 rand. So this is 10 times more expensive, but this is way more powerful. But that's why I take the water out, okay? This I sprayed on the substrate, and I've done that because she's going to go over the substrate and her body's going to go on it. It's also very powerful. And I've taken the water out of the enclosure. So if her body goes in the water and she decides to have a drink, because if this stuff comes off and it comes into the water and then she drinks the water, that's a problem. That could kill her. Guys, I've heard from some breeders, and I'm a bull python and a retic guy. I do have two Dumeril's boas. But I have heard, so please don't quote me on this, that Frontline is lethal for boas. I know I've heard that and carbidust. I know that you can use that for the treatment. The guys sprinkle carbidust on their substrate. I've heard from some boa guards because they're very heavy breathing snakes. As well as retics, you know, they're also heavy breathing snakes. The carbidust, if they inhale it can kill. As well as this Vapona, Frontline will kill boas. But as I say, I'm talking... third-hand information that I'm giving you. I'm only talking to you about my retics and my ball pythons. I use it on my ball pythons, and I use it on my retics. And then, obviously, the third thing is we use this Vapona over here. You see it says poisonous. It comes in an airtight bag. Once you've opened it, that's it. You've got 3 months. So the rest of those blocks there, I'm now going to treat. The snake at the bottom has also got mites. I'm going to treat her, but I'm not going to do it on a video. And I'm going to spray her enclosure down with some BioKill. And then I'm going to put another Tupperware inside there with some Vapona. Guys, and that's how you treat mites. Well, one of the ways how you can treat mites. If you want to know how to do it with ball python, it's pretty much the same. Wipe the ball python down. Spray the enclosure down. I use, you know, some guys will spray the enclosure down with this. This will has also got an ingredient which will kill the eggs of any mites. But then you've got to take all the substrates out of the enclosure and then put new substrate. And I don't want to do that because I've just done her substrate. So I'll see if this works first. The Vapona will kill anything inside there, plus whatever she inhales. But I want to go on too much about this. Guys, if you found this informative, if you found it interesting and you want to see more content like this, please like and subscribe over there. Sorry about the quality of the camera. As I say, I'm doing this on my own. I needed to get this done quickly, and my phone's ringing. It's a Monday morning. It's very early, and I need my phone. I try to tend to my snakes in the morning before work, do what I can, then go to work and come back and tend to my snakes again. So let me get cracking on now with work, now that I've got that done. Well, I need to do that snake quickly. Guys, thank you for watching, all my subscribers, any new subscribers, any people that are watching that haven't subscribed, thank you for watching the channel. I hope to see you again soon. See you on the next video. Over and out from Carl Bellito, South Africa. I want it all.